Well, you may have noticed on our website, waytv.com, that we have a link to a wealth of savory Southern recipes. It is called Southern Plate. Way 31's Director of New Media, Leslie Moody, introduces you to the woman who whips up all of these delectable dishes. Take a look.
Joining me today is Christy Jordan, publisher of SouthernPlate.com. Christy, you've already got quite a big following around not just the Valley, but the world. Welcome. Thanks for being here today.
Thank you for having me. I'm thrilled to be here.
So tell us, you may be famous around the world for this site now, but you're really just a Huntsville girl, right?
Yeah, I'm just from the area. I was born in Huntsville. My dad's retired from the Huntsville Police Department. My mom's a member of the Huntsville Quilt Guild, and I graduated from UNA where I got my home ec degree.
And that turned a completely different course about a year ago. Tell us about that.
It sure did. I had a little free blog online, and I had a friend up north who had never had homemade banana pudding before. And I think your life without homemade banana pudding is pretty much a wasted existence. So I tried to figure out how to tell this person how to make homemade banana pudding, because if you don't know how to cook and you haven't done it before, it's one of those things you kind of need to be shown. So I got an idea to take pictures of every single step, and when I posted it on my blog, it made the company's homepage the next day. And so I did another recipe, and it made the homepage. And I told my husband, I said, I bet if I got my own website, I might get 400 or 500 readers. And so from there, it kind of...
Yeah, you just celebrated 1 year,
yes,
right?
1 year.
And now, how many blog readers are you getting?
I have anywhere from 3 to 5 million page views a month on Southern Blog.
Wow, that's pretty good numbers.
It's amazing.
So it's definitely very different. I mean, the thing that I noticed first about your website is it makes it where a college student can learn to cook, where you mentioned your Yankee outreach. People who've never seen these recipes cooked. Tell us about how you do it that makes it so easy.
What I do is I take photos of every single step, and I try to anticipate questions people are going to have ahead of time, because no one should ever come to Southern Plate and leave feeling like they don't know how to do something. And my premise is anybody can be a wonderful cook. All it takes is the right recipe and a little bit of confidence.
You mentioned the right recipes. Something that also has come up between us is these recipes are your grandmother's, your grandparents', and that part of that was part of the driving factor for Southern Plate. How does that work into the site?
Well, we've got, I have a lot of grandparents, and of course the Southern food heritage is a very cherished one to us. And we've got a couple of generations now who have not had moms at home teach them how to cook. You know, the whole family dynamics have changed. And so people are now wanting these recipes, and maybe grandma has passed on and nobody's taught it. So it's really, my heart is in cherishing these recipes and passing them on and preserving them through Southern Plate. So I really try to do that. And many times I've had someone email me and they say, oh, you know, Granny's fried pies were so wonderful and we've never been able to make them like that. And I tried your fried pies and it was just like she was here with us again. So things like that really mean a lot to me.
Wow, obviously family is important. Your life has changed since you started this blog. How's it different for your family now?
Oh my goodness. My son thinks that I'm famous. He has his own blog, and he says, I am the son of Southern Plate.
And he's how old?
He's 10.
Okay.
The only one who doesn't blog in our family is the 4-year-old, and she's probably coming up soon. But my husband, he works at Dianetics, and he has his own blog, too. And he said, I will forever be known from now on as Christy Jordan's husband. So he gets asked that a lot. Are you Christy Jordan's husband?
And your mom helps, right?
Yes. I could not do this without my mother. No Southerner could do anything without her mother. But Mama mails out all the cookbooks for me, and that's been quite the job, because some days she's going to the post office 2 or 3 times a day to try to keep up with it. So...
Absolutely amazing. You've received some pretty special honors over the past few months. So what are some of the neat things you've been able to do?
Well, Kraft Singles sent me to L.A., and that was really something because I'd never got to leave the South before. So they sent me to L.A., and it was an amazing trip. I got to go on a trip by myself for the first time. I got to ride in a limo. It was limos the entire weekend, limos everywhere. It was just really a unique experience. And I'm writing for Southern Beauty Magazine now. I'm writing for the Food Mag. I'm trying to think, what else? Everything just keeps happening. You know, it's just kind of picking up speed. Right now, Crystal Light is giving away $1,000 on my website this week. So,
fantastic. Yeah. Fantastic. Well, your company, SouthernPlate.com, does have a motto, and that ties into what you're going to be doing for us here at Way TV. Tell us, what is that motto? What's the mission statement?
Feeding the world banana pudding.
Feeding the World Banana Pudding.
Yes, that was the recipe that started it all. And so the mission of Southern Plate is to feed the entire world homemade banana pudding.
Well, watch for Christy coming up here on Way TV. We're going to start filming segments for her next week. And beginning September 2nd, she'll do her first recipe where she'll teach us all how to make banana pudding. Thanks.
Thank you.
All right. We'll look forward.